Have you been looking for a way to add some cool animations to your tiling window manager? Or maybe you want some cool blurring effects? Or maybe you just want rounded corners instead of squared off corners for your tiling window manager? Well, you can do all of this. There are ways to do this. For example, today I'm in XMonad. Notice my XMO bar has rounded corners. Let me open up some terminals. There's the Alacrity terminal with a nice kind of Gaussian blur effect going on there. You notice the rounded corners for Alacrity. Also, notice the animations as I open up more windows. So there's a second window. You notice it kind of comes out from the left-hand side. Let me open up another window and another window. Now let me move some windows around. And I can move windows through the stack, and you see the very fancy animations. Now, how is this achieved? Well, it's actually achieved fairly easily. All you need to do is swap out your standard PyCom or Compton compositor for one of the forks of PyCom that have been patched to include things like rounded corners, animations, blurring. So the fork of PyCom that I'm using is one called, he just calls it PyCom, but if you go to github.com, his name is Jonah Berg, and look for his fork of PyCom. He actually has this packaged up in the Arch user repository, the AUR. I believe if you look for PyCom-JonahBerg-Git, let me double check that to make sure I'm actually telling you guys right. So let me get to my desktop. And if I do a search in yay, actually, let me just do yay-s. Yeah, PyCom-JonahBerg-Git. And if you hit enter, if you already have the standard PyCom installed, it will ask you, do you want to replace the standard PyCom with this particular fork, the JonahBerg fork? And just answer yes to that question. And then what you need is you need a new PyCom config, because the one you're using is not going to work, because this fork of PyCom has some different stuff in it, and they actually have a sample config, and that's all I'm using, is their PyComSample.conf here. And you see, it has some sections regarding animations, you know, exactly what the animations are doing. You can set rounded corners. You can set how big you want the corner radius. You can also exclude certain windows not to have rounded corners. Maybe you don't want notification windows to not have rounded corners or something like that. Maybe you don't want your Firefox web browser, for example, to have rounded corners. So you know, they're excluding Firefox and Thunderbird from having the rounded corners. Then you have information, just standard PyCom information, such as shadowing and opacity and things like that, your standard window rules. And honestly, this default config is all I'm using. I think I maybe changed two or three lines. I excluded some things from having rounded corners. I added some stuff. Now, the one thing I will say, although the blurring effect is kind of nice, I don't care for transparent terminals these days. I just like solid colors. So actually, I'm going to get back into my Alacrity config, and I'm going to go ahead and search for the opacity setting. I had it set to, it looks like 80%, 0.80. I'm going to put that back to 1.0, comment out the opaque line there. And let's write that. And I think that looks a little better, especially since my XMO bar isn't transparent. But anyway, I think this is pretty neat. I think I could add some really interesting screenshots to r/UnixForm using this thing. I do like the animations. The animations maybe are a little slow. They're not sluggish, but you know, I like things happening instantly. I had to adjust my XMO bar config a little bit because by default, XMO bar is, you know, butted up next to the top of the screen, and I had to play with some of the XY positioning to get this slightly in the center of the screen and the rounded corners. One thing that did not work is I did have a sys tray in my XMO bar. It's actually a third-party sys tray called Trayer. It's a standalone application called Trayer. I could not get that thing to appear anywhere except at the very top of the screen. So because it didn't look right, I actually deleted Trayer from XMO bar just for purposes of this video to get this clean look. Another thing that I can't really change the position of is my XMonad prompts, like this my run prompt. And it does have rounded corners, but it's at the very top of the screen. I don't know of any other way to change that, because the only settings I have for the XMonad run prompts are to set it either at the top or the bottom of the screen. There's no XY coordinates. I can't offset it in any way. DMenu I could probably offset, but I'm not currently using DMenu in XMonad. But if you use something like DMenu or Rofi, then you could center those in the middle of the screen. For example, let me see if I can do a Rofi you know, and Rofi does work with the rounded corners, although the border in the rounded corners doesn't quite show up. I don't know. I would have to play around with that a little bit, but I'm not one of these people that tries to put every pixel in exactly the right spot. I don't need to spend that much time, you know, making my desktop look good. You know, mainly I'm after function more than style. Now, I have about 10 or 12 different window managers installed on my system. I have not played with this particular fork of PyCom other than in Xmodad. So I don't know how well it would work in Awesome or Qtile or DWM or anything like that. I imagine it would work just fine in all of those. The reason I'm demonstrating Xmonad is because Xmonad has a third-party panel, Xmobar, that I knew I could adjust the position of it. Where DWM, I don't think you can play with that panel. Like, it has to be at the top of the screen or at the bottom of the screen. You can't offset it in any way, I don't believe. I'm not sure about the Awesome panel or the Qtile panel, but just I wanted to make the sexiest looking desktop I could, showing you guys these animations and these rounded corners, and Xmonad kind of fit the bill for this. Anyway, that was just a very quick video about this particular fork of PyCom. Again, look for Jonah Berg PyCom on GitHub. Those of you on Arch, look for PyCom-JonahBerg-Git in the AUR. Now, before I go, I need to thank a few special people. I need to thank Devin Friend, Gabe Corbinian, Mitchell Akami, Arch5530, Chris, Chuck, David, The Other David, Donnie, Dylan, Gregory, Lewis, Paul, PickVM, Scott, and Willie. They are the producers of the show. They are my highest tier patrons over on Patreon. The show is also brought to you by each and every one of these ladies and gentlemen as well. These are all my supporters over on Patreon because the DistroTube channel is sponsored by the community. And if you'd like to support my work, I'd appreciate it. Look for DistroTube over on Patreon. All right, guys. Peace.